Well, on the Sea of Galilee, Jesus brought his disciples and taught them a couple of pretty profound lessons. Number one, he was in the boat with them and he fell asleep. And I love that. It speaks of the humanity of Jesus. He got tired, just like you and I do. He had a snooze. And in that time, a storm whipped up on the lake. And on Galilee, it can suddenly become very stormy. The basin can create that, especially late afternoon. So Jesus is asleep. The disciples, who are fishermen, get terrified. They wake him up and say, "Master, we're going to drown." And he stands up in a beautiful moment. He speaks to nature. I mean, who is this, right? He speaks to the wind and it goes quiet. He speaks to the waves and they become still. And I love the disciples' reaction. It says this, they were afraid in the storm, but after he'd calmed the storm, it says, Mark says, and they were filled with great fear and said to one another, "Who is this then, that even the wind and the waves obey him?" The fear went up, even though the storm calmed down, when they realized that Jesus is none other than the incarnate presence of God who created this world and can calm it down in a storm. Isn't it good news that Jesus can calm storms? Whatever storm we might be facing in life, he's the one who can calm it. Anyway, second incident, this time he's not in the boat. The disciples are going across the lake and he comes out walking on the water, which is quite some achievement. And as he walks out on the water, the disciples see him and most of the disciples stay in the boats. They want to be spectators, watching what Jesus can do. But as Peter sees this, he's a true disciple. He wants to be like the rabbi, the master. And so he gets up and he says, "Master, let me come to you." Can you imagine that moment when Peter actually stepped out of the boat and his foot stood on the water and he walked out with Jesus on the water? Now that's faith. Faith is not staying in the boat and seeing what Jesus can do. Faith is getting out of the boat and putting our trust in Jesus in real terms. If you want to walk on water, you've got to get out of the boat. That's what it really means to follow Jesus, not to be a spectator. Let's not be spectators who always play it safe. Let's be those who take some risks for Jesus and see what only he can do when we really trust him. Well, those are two amazing examples of how Jesus taught his disciples right here on the Sea of Galilee. He calmed the storm and he walked on water on this beautiful lake here in Israel.